What's up, everyone? John from Beyond AR TV. Welcome back to another episode of Hate It or Love It. Today, we're talking about the Ohio Hometown Heroes 21 Pilots, a band and a duo, I should say, that took over the world. They're currently on a bit of a break, a hiatus, as the fans are calling it, and today we're going to be looking at six reasons the internet and people online seem to hate 21 Pilots. Now keep in mind that with this series in general, and obviously this episode too, these are not my reasons. I will agree and disagree as we go on, but these are reasons that I found from searching all over the place, whether it be Twitter, Reddit, various critical websites, etc., etc. But these are other people's reasonings that I will give the point and then I will weigh in, so keep that in mind while you're watching. Please, if you enjoyed the video today, drop a like on it and subscribe if you are new here. Let me know what other bands or artists you would like to see me do this with, and let's get right into it with my first point. A huge factor for really enjoying or getting into any band is you have to like the vocalist, at least to some extent, and many people do not find enjoyment in Tyler Joseph's voice. I think the main gripe that I've seen is that it's too whiny, it's too pitchy, and they don't like the way that he shifts back and forth between rapping and singing, and when he does sing, they don't like the style or the flow of it. And that is a valid complaint for some people because I cannot say how other people perceive things. If they're not just blindly spewing hate and saying, look at this little whiny emo dude, that obviously not justified. But if you don't like a singer's voice, you don't. It works that way sometimes. I personally am obviously a fan of Tyler Joseph's voice. I wouldn't be able to get into their music as much as I have if I didn't enjoy it, but I like the quality that keeps it kind of humble, kind of real, down to earth. It feels like his voice occasionally trembles as he sings, especially on some of the quieter moments, even off of newer albums like Blurry Face. Moments like Goner are great examples of that. He's able to transition between rapping and singing, but it's not gonna be for everyone. Number 2, confusing lyrical content. I've seen a lot of raised hands for this one saying, I don't get it when it comes to their lyrics, but I think the main misconception here is the fact that they're maybe trying to be fake deep or they're trying to be something that they're not. I honestly think a lot of their messages that are hidden within the songs are deeper, and sometimes people take things literally or at surface level. And that's not just with 21 Pilots, but 21 Pilots being marketed as the band that they are, this deeper emo leaning band that has a lot of messages in their music. People take phrases or words and they're like, oh, well, they're getting at this and that's just silly. I think that with the confusing lyrical messages of 21 Pilots' music, it sometimes takes repeated listens. It takes reading along with these songs and trying to understand what Joseph is getting at. Messages of suicide awareness, depressed thoughts, and even hope are built into the messages of their songs. And while I won't say that every song is flawless in the way that it presents it, still, I think that most of the time they're putting good messages out there, even if they're kind of misrepresented or even misread. We were just putting off the inevitable with this one. It's number 3, the cringy fan base. This ruins it for so many people, and honestly, it's gotten to me at times. It's not something that's actively bothered me anytime recently, considering I'm normally positive towards 21 Pilots' music because I'm a fan of 21 Pilots and most of the stuff that they put out there in the world. But damn, the fans are just awful. I'm talking about like the skeleton clique hardcores, the ones that obsess over them and protect them and try to protect them, I should say, like they're babies. It's just, some bands I've seen it bad. This is the worst that I have ever seen it. It's the skeleton clique, and it's mainly teenagers, it seems like, that are really passionate about them. And there's nothing wrong with being passionate about the music, but they take it to a whole nother level. They act like they walk on water, like they're the gods of music, like they're the best thing ever. And I totally understand why some people get turned off by that. People think, oh, John, you can't not get into a band because of their fan base. But imagine trying to like leave a comment on a video saying, oh, you know, this is a pretty good song, like on House of Gold, the music video or something like that. And then like 18 fans reply saying, oh, it's okay, it's only okay. You don't even understand the hidden messages within the video and the song, etc., etc., etc. It's just like, shut up for a second, please. I've seen the click do some absolutely outrageous stuff towards other people, sending waves of hate people's way, and just trying to take people down. And the way that they dive into the duo's personal lives, it's a bit disturbing, the things that they're after. Now, I do love the fact that there is a strong knit community of teenagers that do embrace the message stay alive and they talk about positivity, but damn, it gets weighed down by these other toxic fans. Please let the other ones come to the surface. Let those be the stronger ones, not these toxic voices that we need to stamp out. Believe it or not, I've seen a fair amount of people take issue with the fact that 21 Pilots bring religion into their music. Now, Josh Dunn and Tyler Joseph are both outspoken about their faith and the fact that they are Christians, and I myself being a Christian as well, I thought that was cool because a lot of people do not want to speak out on their faith, and they'll be like, well, I don't like to put a label on it, you know, I just believe that everybody's right, but you know that they actually do have their beliefs, they're just too afraid to say them, and I think that nobody should be afraid to speak out. If you're a Buddhist, if you're a monk, if you're from the Catholic Church, or you're whatever you're from, it doesn't matter your background. And people do seem to hate on 21 Pilots, not so much, but still it's out there for the fact that they bring up God and other associations of religion into the lyrical content of their music. Now, granted, you do have to kind of search for it, but a lot of the allusions that are put into their music, the things that they put out there and say, maybe this represents God, or maybe this is about a higher power or something like that, a lot of people put the connections together and they're like, oh, they're getting preachy about it. But then I have to circle back to the fact that you just had to do a deep dive in order to put that together in the first place, because these songs are open for interpretation purposefully. I think that Tyler Joseph writes in that direction for a reason. So if you're working so hard to put the puzzle pieces together and say, oh, this is a religious track, I don't like this, then maybe you shouldn't be doing that, and maybe you should just be trying to enjoy the music for what it is. Oh, the pitfalls of getting famous. Number 5, overrated and overplayed. Overplayed is an accurate representation because 21 Pilots, as with most acts that just blow up into the mainstream, they do get played too much on the radio and playlist in general. Your friends are all playing them and they're like, oh, look at this new thing that I discovered, it's the best thing ever. And then they like proceed to play Ride like 15 times in a row on Spotify. Yeah, you're talking about your annoying friends and the radio in general just beat some of their songs to death. I'm talking Ride, Stressed Out, and Heathens. Those are the big ones right there that everyone knew, and they were big in the top 10 of the Hot 100. Now, overplayed is kind of out of the band's control, but overexposed, overrated, those kind of get tagged onto them as well, and they did spend a good amount of time in the spotlight, thanks to huge tours and many successful music videos, and obviously the songs themselves. It does make them a little bit overexposed in the process, people get annoyed, and then you get the accusations of them being overrated, and people forget that the band's image isn't actually the music itself. Pay attention to the music, not the merch, not the image of the band. If you're going to judge them based on anything, judge them based on the quality of their music. Now, overplayed, yeah, I get it. I understand why people say that. Some of their songs were beat into the ground, but give it some time off. Step away from the radio, step away from the playlist, step away from your friend that's playing them to death, and come back in 6 months. Maybe you'll feel better. The final point and reason that I'm bringing up today is the emo aesthetic that the band has. Many people feel like it's kind of this faux identity that they identify with for the simple fact that they can market it to teens and teens are going to relate to it. Think like people say about Black Veil Brides, but on a more extreme level. Now with Black Veil Brides, I would probably agree with that, with the fact that they don't even try with the lyrical content to make it creative or anything like that. But with 21 Pilots, it's more of a complicated issue because you could say that they're pandering, but how would we really know? Because it seems like Tyler Joseph and Josh Dunn, but Joseph I would say to a more extreme point, have been through a lot with anxiety, depression, and just feeling out of touch with happiness. And I think that he does write from a genuine place, but I think that some people just get caught up in seeing them with that eyeliner or the stuff around their eyes and under it and the image that they put on and the ski mask and the dark clothes or the red clothes or whatever it is they're wearing on their tour or in their music video. And people say, oh, they're gonna be this. They are this. And then they only listen to one or two songs because they're emo. And they're like, oh, didn't that die out forever ago? But it's an interesting thing because people don't seem to give them a chance past their image a lot of the time. And they say, oh, they're just this cringy band for teenagers. But I think myself and other fellow critics, some of us at least, have looked past that and looked into their music. And we've found a lot of light there. A lot of light and a lot of life and a lot of enjoyable tracks. So think what you will about their aesthetic and their emo-ness, but try to look past that and look into the songs themselves. I hope you guys enjoyed this video on 6 reasons why the internet hates 21 Pilots. Let me know what you think in the comments section down below. Like I said, what other bands or artists should I do this with? Leave a comment and upvote some of the ones that you say that you really want me to do in the future. Make sure you're subscribed if you are brand new so you don't miss out on any other of my videos that are coming out very soon, and drop a like. If you're able to support me on Patreon, it would be greatly appreciated. It is this annotation over in the corner of the screen there. If you would like to see a 21 Pilots review, click right here, or another recent video I made on the channel right over here. Thanks for watching another episode of Hate It or Love It right here on Beyond AR TV. I'll see you very soon.